Penguin Random House Audio presents The Life-Giving Leader, Learning to Lead from Your Truest Self. Written and read by Tyler Reagin, with forewords written by Craig Groeschel and Andy Stanley, and read by Richard Brewer. Foreword by Craig Groeschel. Years ago, when I first met Tyler Reagin, two things stood out immediately. First, Tyler is crazy passionate about Jesus. Second, Tyler is obsessed with building great leaders. During our first conversation, I knew instantly we would become friends. But I had no idea we'd end up working closely together to empower leaders who love the local church. Now, almost a decade later, I've had the privilege of serving with and learning from one of the greatest servant leaders I've ever met. In title, Tyler is president of Catalyst. But his heart and gifts extend far beyond any title or label. Tyler's love for people is contagious. I've watched him inspire thousands of people from on stage, and in the next moment, focus on encouraging an insecure intern. I've seen Tyler strategically solve complex problems and intentionally shape a culture over time. I've watched him win the trust of spiritually disinterested people and lead them closer to the things of God. Because of Tyler's leadership and vision, he's gathered some of the nation's top leaders to generously invest in others at Catalyst conferences in cities around the world. One of my mentors told me, "You can learn from any leader. Sometimes you learn what you want to do, other times you learn what you never want to do." Unfortunately, most of us have been exposed to leaders we don't want to emulate. If you have ever served under a controlling, critical, or insecure leader, you know firsthand the challenges dysfunctional leadership can create. You might have felt hesitant, afraid, demoralized, or discouraged. Unhealthy leaders create unhealthy environments. They can suck the life out of an organization. Thankfully, Tyler shows us a better way to lead in his new book, The Life-Giving Leader. Rather than demanding loyalty, a life-giving leader first extends trust. Instead of controlling followers, a life-giving leader empowers other leaders. Rather than talking down to people, a life-giving leader develops people so they can do more than they thought possible. If you want to grow in your leadership, this is the perfect book for you. But let me warn you, there are no shortcuts. The road isn't easy. As I've heard Tyler say before, leadership isn't easy. It's difficult because it matters. It changes people. It's valuable. And things of value require sacrifice. I promise you, the principles Tyler writes about are practical, powerful, and time-tested. This book will push you, stretch you, and help you grow. And as you apply what you learn, you will become more like the one who gave his life that we might live. You will become a life-giving leader. Craig Groeschel, Senior Pastor of Life Church. Foreword by Andy Stanley. Great leaders breathe life into the leaders around them. Insecure leaders? Not so much. You will do one or the other. There is no third option. You will be included in the stories of the men and women who reported to you or worked alongside you. When they tell their stories, you'll get a mention. Either you'll be the boss, manager, or team lead who spoke to their potential, allowed them to shine, and was quick to give credit where it was due, or you'll be that other boss. The one who hoarded the credit. The one so consumed by his own career that he gave little or no thought to helping the next generation. The one easily threatened by new talent, fresh ideas, and outside-the-box thinking. Regardless of your personal success and achievements, when the folks who reported to you tell their stories, you'll be scored pass or fail. While it's unlikely they'll use this exact terminology, they will remember you as either a life-giving leader or a leader who drained life out of them. You'll be celebrated as the leader who put wind in their sails, or you'll be remembered as a headwind, someone who impeded the progress and achievements of those you led. The choice is yours. The choice is yours every day. As counterintuitive as it may sound, it is actually in your best interests to become, as my friend Tyler puts it, a life-giving leader. The value of a life is always determined by how much it is given away. Funerals teach us that. Over the course of your marketplace or ministry career, you'll have endless opportunities to give your life away. What you do with those opportunities will define you. How you respond to those opportunities will determine your legacy. Live for yourself, and you'll have only yourself to show for yourself in the end. But when you give your life away, when you choose to breathe life into the people around you, you'll not only add value to the lives of others, but you'll make your life more valuable as well. Tyler summarizes it perfectly. When life flows, influence grows. I've known, worked with, and worked for Tyler for over 12 years. He is the embodiment of this book. His personal and career successes underscore the enduring principles he teases out for his readers. If you want to have more than yourself to show for yourself, this book will help you get there. Andy Stanley, North Point Ministries.
This is the author, Tyler Reagin. Introduction. A Charge. Have you ever felt as if God has given you a message to share? How about a theme your life has been focused on? If you had one chance to tell the world the thoughts that guide you, what would you say? These interrelated questions push me to write this book. Among examples of poor leadership and glimmers of hope and great leadership, I feel called to steward one message. It all comes down to life-giving leadership. Life-giving leadership can change the game. It can change work environments almost instantly. It can change church culture. It should be the norm. Early in this journey, I asked my sons what they thought I should write about. I was curious to see where they think my passions lie. My older son responded with a smirk, quickly saying, "Leadership." He laughed and said, "That's all I talk about anyway." My younger son followed up with a one-word answer, "Jesus." I told them if I wrote a book on Jesus and leadership, then I could probably cover most of my thoughts on the life I want to lead. The pursuit of life-giving leadership begins and ends with Jesus. My faith is central to my leadership, and it has directed my life for 25 years and will continue to do so. But why am I writing about leadership and not about some other pressing need? First, we're seeing a crisis of leadership that won't be addressed until Jesus' followers step up and through their leadership bring life to others. Whether you serve as a leader on the staff of a church, work in education, lead a nonprofit organization, or head a for-profit corporation, it is essential that you see the importance of how you lead. The way you lead is mission critical for great organizations, because as a leader, you represent something bigger than just yourself. Jesus gives us the best picture of how leaders should lead. Leadership should focus on bringing life to others. Jesus brought life to people during his time on earth, and he continues to do so today. It only makes sense that leading and life-giving go hand in hand. Leaders, what if your greatest legacy was that people found life through your leadership? Imagine if your fingerprint was seen not only in your organization, team, and family, but also in many organizations, teams, and families. Welcome to life-giving leadership. One of my favorite passages in the Old Testament book of Ezekiel is known as the Valley of Dry Bones. Have you ever felt as if your soul and even life itself had become brittle and dry, lacking fullness and abundance? I believe we all have at one time or another. That's why I'd like you to listen to this passage with leadership in mind. Think about work environments that felt similar to this awful valley. The hand of the Lord was on me, and he brought me out by the Spirit of the Lord and set me in the middle of a valley. It was full of bones. He led me back and forth among them, and I saw a great many bones on the floor of the valley, bones that were very dry. He asked me, "Son of man, can these bones live?" I said, "Sovereign Lord, you alone know." Then he said to me, "Prophesy to these bones and say to them, 'Dry bones, Hear the word of the Lord. This is what the Sovereign Lord says to these bones. I will make breath enter you, and you will come to life. I will attach tendons to you, and make flesh come upon you, and cover you with skin. I will put breath in you, and you will come to life. Then you will know that I am the Lord.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.